Hi friends, in this video we are going to know in detail about TCS NQT. TCS NQT 2021 is totally different from previous years. So there is so much of need to know if you have a dream to work in TCS. Is this NQT useful for non-IT students to get their course-side jobs? Is this adaptive test pattern? Is it possible to get TCS digital job through NQT? Is there any negative marking? What is the syllabus? If you know all these things well, we can go with a perfect strategy of preparation to crack TCS written test. So let me discuss about all these things in clear. NQT is National Qualifier Test. Eligible candidates for the test are graduates from 2019, 2020, 2021 and 2022 years. Here, BTech and MTech graduates from all branches are eligible. And also, Diploma, BSc, MSc and MCA students are also eligible. This test is for both IT and non-IT jobs. Based on NQT scores, not only TCS will recruit you, NQT results will be shared with many other companies like Tata Group companies or non-Tata Group companies, that is IT and non-IT companies also. Based on your scores, you will get call from different companies for direct interviews. Your scores valid for 2 years. If you are aiming to get placed in software companies, it's mandatory to attempt programming skill test. If you are aiming for other than software jobs, that is mechanical or civil or electrical or electronics course side jobs, just you have to go for one more test, that is industry NQT, which is branch specific test, which will be activated after completion of TCS hiring. But for both software and non-software recruitments, reasoning, arithmetic and verbal are mandatory. TCS going to follow adaptive test pattern. Means you cannot go to the previous questions once you move to next question. That is unidirectional attempt. Here you should not move your eyes or head. Everything will be recorded. I heard as you are not supposed to take your own rough sheet. You have to do your rough work in the rough area provided by TCS. This instruction is mainly for the students who are trying to attempt from your home. Coming to test pattern in detail, we are having two main parts. First one is mandatory NQT and second one is subject NQT. Here, mandatory NQT consisting of three sections. Section one is verbal ability. Here, 30 minutes will be given to solve 24 questions. Section 2 is reasoning ability. Here 50 minutes will be given to solve 30 questions. And section 3 is numerical ability. Here 30 minutes will be given to solve 24 questions. This mandatory NQT plays a major role in selection process. Coming to subject NQT, this is mandatory for TCS and other IT companies where they use it to check your coding skills. Here 10 programming logical questions will be there to answer in 15 minutes. These are multiple choice questions. Two codes will be asked to write programs. First code is to complete in 15 minutes. Second code is to complete in 30 minutes. I think second code will be difficult. Here to write and execute the programs, we can use any of the C, CPP, Java or Python 2.7 programming languages. Depending on the scores you are getting in this test, you may get a chance to attend for TCS digital interview. If you crack it, your package will be 7 lakhs per annum. If you cannot crack TCS digital, you will be safe with Ninja. That is, if your performance in interview is satisfactory, you will be get TCS Ninja profile with 3.6 lakhs per annum package. There is no negative marking. This is one of the best thing. And virtual calculator will be given. Coming to syllabus, in verbal ability section, there is a chance of asking different questions like synonyms, antonyms, sentence completion, reading comprehension, grammar, that is prepositions, articles, tenses, direct and indirect speeches, active and passive voice, error detection, error corrections, sentence improvements, etc. Coming to reasoning, there is a chance of asking huge number of questions from coding and decoding, number series, letter series, blood relations, directions, seating arrangements, syllogisms, that is deductions, odd man out, analogy, that is number analogy, letter analogy, word analogy, etc. Coming to numerical ability, that is arithmetic, percentages, simple interest and compound interest, profit and loss, ratios and proportions, time and work, time and distance, numbers, mensuration, permutations and combinations, probability, data interpretation, data sufficiency, simple equations, ages, averages, mixes and allegations. Here most important topics are averages, mixes and allegations, simple equations, ages and percentages. Coming to programming logic, there is a chance of asking some multiple choice of questions from data structures, C, CPP, Java, etc. And there will be two codes in programming. All the questions will be here asked indirectly. Maximum logics will be from reasoning and arithmetic. Usually asking logics for programming are reversing a string, reversing a number, palindrome of numbers, palindrome of strings, prime numbers, leap year, greatest among 10 given numbers, Fibonacci series, HCF and LCM, factorial values, decimal to binary conversions or binary to decimal conversions, converting one number system into another number system, Armstrong numbers, swapping of two numbers, concatenate two strings, average of numbers, sum of digits of a number, progressions related logics, simple and compound interest, etc. Don't waste your time sticking at single question. Don't try for tough questions spending more time. Answer carefully. Your efforts in solving aptitude questions will decide your eligibility for TCS digital profile. So work hard for these few days. Revise the topics number of times. Go with conceptual analysis with comparative study. Check for option verifications and option eliminations. These two things may help you to mark answers easily. Follow our channel for live classes every day on TCS NQT. Let us be a part of your success. TCS is the best platform to work. Work hard with strong determination and dedication. All the very best. Congratulations in advance. Thank you. This is your Mahesh.